Welcome back, everyone. It's February 13th, and we're halfway through Black History Month. Unfortunately, painful terms are part of our history, history that we shouldn't gloss over. Tonight, we continue the conversation on the N-word.
N-word, it has like a deep history.
The word that you're not supposed to use anymore.
I don't even like using the word because I'm older now. But it's like, we just been immune to it, so we do use it. But in our reality, it's stereotyped to make us look like fools.
Definitely with the R at the end, like, I feel like that's more of like, you're trying to come at me.
The N-word with an A at the end is kind of like a word that Black people can use to greet each other. With an ER, I think that's just like racist.
My dad used that as well as other derogatory terms. Towards people of the Black race. That's just how he talked. Dad did not like Black people. And he didn't like the idea that he had to do business with them.
I actually recall the first time somebody called me that word. It's something that really takes you off guard and knocks your barriers down. Makes you feel helpless.
Do I think the word should be abolished completely? Well, I kind of do, but I also think that there's such power behind connotations of words.
Whenever I hear that word, I never forget the trauma that's associated with it. And I know sometimes it's not used within my community as that context.
When you ask me if I know the history, no, I just know that it was used. To me, it's a variation of Negro.
I associate that word with slavery. I don't know exactly where the word originated.
Anything that helps us navigate life and understand how what we say affects people, because that's what we do, I think that's important.
Learning is important. And if you dig deep, you'll discover throughout American history, the word was used in nursery rhymes. For example, eeny, meeny, miny, moe, catch up by its toe. You probably know the version with tiger, which was later substituted for the N-word. From nursery rhymes to schools across the Twin Cities, that word is still causing pain. Monday, an incident in Owatonna.
The chief of police says the posts were made by a few white students and were directed at Black students.
Back in December, it showed up on a rock at Burnsville High School.
It shouldn't be something that we need to handle, especially at school. Like, I come here to get an education.
In December, on a student's shirt in Chaska.
At the end of the email, it was just like, we got him a new shirt and that's it.
Move on.
After completing several reports, I noticed a common thread. Many school districts said they had a no-tolerance policy for this type of language. But still, it was happening. We wanted to find a solution. So I asked my news director, what could we do? So tonight, here's a mini history lesson on why that word causes so much pain.
Every Black person has their own N-word story, which is to say that they remember the first time they were called that by somebody white. Everybody has that story. For me, I was 14 years old and I was in Cairo, Egypt. We were in a pool and the young white guy used the word toward me.
The N-word is an alternative to what some people won't say.
Judge Lance Ito, you can say either to his credit or it was a terrible decision. He did not want that word used in his courtroom.
He was the judge presiding over the O.J. Simpson murder trial in the 90s. The racial slur appeared in court transcripts documenting officer comments concerning Simpson.
Mark Furman and other law enforcement officials in L.A. apparently used that word. Not only to apprehend O.J., but had used that word in
the
history.
The Simpson trial birthed the term N-word, which has led to what Mays calls historical amnesia.
A racial hatred, which has manifested in Black folks dying, being killed at the hands of white mobs.
But before the Simpson case, the word was used without hesitation. The original spelling of the Latin word, N-I-G-E-R, meant black. Later, it took on a derogatory connotation and was used to describe
my name,
African slaves.
It's Toby.
Hi. That's a good
lynchings, people being burned at stakes. This is what you do to Black people if they step out of place. So that's what the word is all about. You can't detach the N-word from that torrid historical legacy of white mob violence.
Mays, a professor of African and African American studies at the University of Minnesota, says to understand present headlines with Virginia's governor linked to blackface, we must revisit the past.
That word is associated with hundreds of years of not only racial abuse, racial oppression.
When teaching the history, Mays explains how the word was used as an attempt to scare Hank Aaron, a black baseball player, from breaking Babe Ruth's home run record.
Dear Mr. I hope you don't break the Babe's record. How can I tell my kids that a did it? Dear, you can hit all them home runs over them short fences, but you can't take that black off your face. See, that ties in the black face minstrelsy. See, that's all related, the overlaps.
How do you respond to, for today's youth, the word just means dude or buddy? What's up, Ma? What's up?
For whom?
It's in hip hop culture, rappers use it, and I hear black boys and girls use that word all the time.
If white people invented the word to abuse, to maim, to kill black people, then African Americans are duty bound within the context of their long freedom struggle, the black freedom struggle, to take something that white people created to hurt them and to kill them and remake it, and to diffuse the power that the word has historically over them. It has inhibited, to some degree, white people using the word. So white people just want to reclaim their power to use it, but that's a power that black and brown people should never give up. Just like the Jews should never give up the power to police the boundaries of anti-Semitic talk and behavior. You just cannot, because you fought so long to achieve a certain end, if we give people passes to use it, what are we saying to our ancestors? What are we saying to black folks who are alive today? And certainly, what are we saying to our history?
The past, no matter how tumultuous, it must be recognized. We don't want to ignore that word never existed, but we don't want to deflate the power associated with it. Don't let the conversation end here. Keep your comments coming online. We're back after this break.